Okay, so we're going to start at the bottom end, and we're going to do that. The bottom is perfectly fine for whatever size. I don't think anybody is, but as we approach up, we're actually just marginally widening it up, and as we approach the thigh area, we're going to widen this up, and then the crotch area, we're going to widen this up. So what we've done is started with about 1.5 inches and a gradual decrease as we've gone down. Oh god, it's hard working on the floor, I tell you. I'm not used to sitting on the floor and doing this. So, and the floor is actually laminate, so everything slips. If you've got a carpet, then you're not too bad. The carpet actually clings, the fabric clings to the carpet, but when you're doing this, again, I've margined it out slightly and left a slight bit of a room. So that is the roof marking for a 2 size up from what I've cut out. And my reckoning is that this would fit up to a size 14, maybe even a size 16. And then anything above that, the one that I'm cutting would probably fit a size 18. So there's something that I'm going to teach you before we go on to this is one that we are restricted, even though I've got a massive floor, I'm restricted on movement here. And two, working on a full stomach is no fun. I was at Lauren's house earlier and I had a meal there, so I'm absolutely stuffed as well. Yeah, I've been going mad drinking water. So working on a full stomach is not ideal. Now we're going to fine-tune this before we actually go any further and cut the next one. And fine-tuning it is you grab hold of the corners and you turn them over. Because the last thing you want is to form a twist in your chooridar. So if you fold over your pieces like this, and you fold that side of it down as well, and allow for the seaming of this seam, and then you want the excess trimmed down a little bit. That's not meeting perfectly. So what we're going to do is we're going to trim this down to perfect size. And this look should look arched like a crotch seam. We're going to just fine tune this to make sure that there's no, the seaming is absolutely equal for both the pieces. Now this is so easy to do. And then if you work down, make sure that your points at the bottom of your poncha are meeting up, and just trim it to size. And that is one side of the chooridar formed. So this fabric, then we need to go and lay on top of this. And the way we're going to lay this is like this, and then we're going to go and take that piece and actually just, and we're going to cut an exact identical piece as the one that we've already got. So you can play about with this, and with this much fabric you can go up to a size 22, 24. So now all you're doing is cutting exactly the same, and you should have an absolute perfectly formulated chooridar that will, you will be able to stitch in literally minutes. So what you witnessed here is me using the template, which is in a size 14. I've amended that to a larger size with marginal allowance, and really cut this on the floor, same as all you guys in front of you. So that's an inspiration to follow exactly what I do, to go on and make this in your own size. So I really can't wait to get the packs out to you, and I want to see the results of everybody making and wearing these. Okay, I am absolutely exhausted now. That's it. That's about as much strength as I had. Okay, so we are going to belt this, and what I want to do is the excess pieces that we've had left over, which are these two pieces, and we're going to create the belt exactly the same in a bias cut. So first of all, we want to angle this out, and the belt doesn't need to be a lot. We only need the belt of about 5 inches. So we're just gonna randomly cut this. And that's our fully cut chooridar, folded and ready for stitching. Oh, that's it, I've had it now.